I am Sayed Hamid, and today I am going to introduce you to one of the Python libraries which I have recently developed for handling IMD radar data. IMD means Indian Meteorological Department. Now, this library is exclusively for IMD data only. Basically, it converts single sweeps to cf-radial data, which can be used in input for Pyart, Wradlib, and other libraries like that. So without further ado, let's get started. Basically, I'm going to start from scratch. First of all, what we are going to do, we are going to open a browser and then go to github.com. Now, in GitHub, just search for PyScanCf. Now, you can click on the first one. Here, go down and go to readme section. Here, you can see the description of this library and other details as well. So, what we are going to do, I'll just show you how to create a Conda environment, and then how to install this library, and then how to use it. So just copy these lines here. You can copy all at once and go to your terminal, or in case of Windows, open your command prompt and paste these commands here. Let's hit enter. It will create an environment. It will then activate it automatically, and it will install this library. Just hit Y and enter. Okay, so this library has been installed. You can also verify it if here it is written as PCF. If you have followed my instructions, then there should be written this PCF. So basically, it is our new environment. And in that environment, we have installed that PyScanCf library. Now open your Jupyter or any other IDE if you are using Spider, or just Python. Okay. Now I do not have data in this one. So what I'll do, I'll just quit it. I'm just switching to my hard drive. So let's go to hard drive. Okay. So here you can see my test IMD test data. Let's go to that folder. Let me clear everything first. So here you can see I have these 10 data files from IMD radar, IMD Goa radar. Each file represents single scan. So what the PyScanCf does is it merges this data into one file. So basically, this file here, if you see, the first file is the lowest scan, which has been taken at lowest elevation, and the last scan, this one, has been taken at the highest elevation. IMD follows some kind of this routine that they take 10 sweeps for full volume of atmosphere. Now let's go to let's open Jupyter again. Okay, now you can see my data clearly here. Now what I will do is I will create a notebook. Okay, let's import our PyScanF. Now what I'll type is, I'll type from PyScanCf import PyScanCf as PCF. Hit a shift enter, and you will see this library is importing. Okay, this is our data, you can see here. Now if we want to use our library to create polar data or grid data or plots as well. So what I will do here, I will just type okay, we'll create some other folder in which we will store that data. So I will import OS and I'll create one directory for output. Let's say output. Let's give it a name of output. Okay. Now if you hit ls again, you will see this output directory here. Now we are going to store that data in this directory. Okay, let's use our library now, PyScanF. So I'll type PCF because this is the alias I have used in the first cell. So here PCF dot CF rad. Now what it will do, it will look for the data automatically and it will create polar as well as gridded data. Now for using cf-rad, we need two directories. Basically what we need is, we need input data directory where our input data is this data, and we need output directory. Now how, what we will type is, we'll type input directory and output directory. Okay, now we'll mention a path here. Now how are you going to look for this path? I'll just type pwd, which is present working directory, or you can also use this OS. Okay, now my path is this. I'll just type it here, and for this output I'll type this path here. Now it is done. Yeah, for for looking this path, you can also use os.getcwd, get current working directory, and if you hit enter, you will see the same result. Open this. I have opened this notebook in that directory only, so that's why it is showing this directory. Now for output, I have used this directory, which is in the inside this IMD test data directory. So let's give this input. First one, you will use input directory, and input directory is equal to input directory. Okay, this input directory basically refers to this one, and for output directory we'll type here output directory. Okay, output directory is equal to output directory. Now if you want to see what other parameters I am going to use in this, just hit shift and tab. You will see what functions, what attributes this cf-rad function has. Now here we also have to use gridder as well as plot. Now what is gridder and what is plot? Gridder basically converts the data into gridded format, I mean into Cartesian coordinates. So it will take care of that. And this plot means, now before starting this video, I showed you one picture of some cyclone, if you remember. Now let me show you again. Okay, this one. So that plot is going to do that thing. But we have to take care of that, because if you see, if you hit shift and enter again, and you will see what I have to type there. Now I can use REF, which refers to reflectivity, or VELH, which is radial velocity, horizontal radial velocity, width, which represents spectral width, or if you want all of the plots, just type all. Now we can hit enter, shift and enter. I'm sorry, we did not run this. Okay, let's run it and run it again. Now we have to wait for this, it will take some time. Okay, we can go to our directory, we can check whether this data is processing or not. Now if you see, here are some plots generated, and if we go into this output directory, now here are other files as well. Yeah, now this grid file means it is gridded file. Gridded means it is in Cartesian coordinates, and this polar file means which is in polar coordinates. So you can use any file according to your wish. Okay, our plots are getting generated. Let's see what is going on in the notebook. Oh, nice plots. If we further check our data, our output data, we can import Pyart. Have I imported that? No. We can import Pyart. Import Pyart. We can also import matplotlib. Okay, now let's check first our polar file. Okay, polar data file. Now I'll type Pyart. Now this is the Pyart's function, it's not this library's function, but yeah, this is the best library available, this one Pyart, as well as Wradlib for radar data. Now I'll go to output and I'll read this polar file. Okay, okay, now let's create display for plotting these pictures. Now what we can do is we can display dot plot. Now display dot plot, what we are going to plot is, okay, now let's see what is in our data file. We can also type radar dot info to check what parameters we have got in this file. You can also see keys. Okay, now we have four parameters here, which is reflectivity, radial velocity, spectral width, and total power. Now let's check this reflectivity. Okay, I'll check sweep one. Okay, sweep zero represent sweep, first sweep here. If you are wondering why this plot doesn't look like this, color schemes. Okay, yeah, a little. Actually we can also use read grid function, it will read our gridded data. Now let's read our gridded data. Anyone. Okay, now we have to create again display. Now display, you can name it as grid display. Okay, grid display or whatever you like. So pyart dot graph dot grid map display, and here we'll type this radar object. Okay, now grid display will do the same thing, but in this case the data is in Cartesian coordinates, right? So grid display, what we are going to plot is reflectivity at which level? At first level, or maybe second level, maybe third level. Let's type fifth level is equal to Z and all, or whatever you like, or this one as well, Pyart. And here we can also type vmin is equal to, let's type 10, and vmax is. So if you want to suppress this data, you can just make those values values below 10, we can make those nan, right? So let's make those nan just for a trial. Okay, if grid reflectivity is less than 10, make those values nan. Okay, okay, so let's import numpy as np. Now let's give it a try. We can plot it, right? So let's plot it. Okay, we'll first check what's its shape. So it's 40. Here I have used fifth level. Now what we can do is we can plt dot contour f the data is gone. Okay, now here we can also use levels is equal to np dot a range, or simply a range of range from 10 to 60 comma 1. Okay, let's type. See, it's almost matching. Okay, so what other things you can do is you can convert it to rain. Suppose let's use Marshall-Palmer relationship. So let's convert it to rain. So we have gref, or we can just simply use some other library, for example Wradlib. Just import Wradlib here. Okay, now we don't have to do this. We'll convert this dbz to z first. Okay, so for that wrl, Wradlib is having one function named as trefo. Okay, trefo dot idecimal. Now let's use this one. Now it will convert this dbz to z. Okay, just keep it capital Z in case. Now what we can do is we can convert this z to rain. Okay, now type rain here, wrl dot, okay, dot zr, zr, let's plot it for fifth level. Okay, it's having more than 10, so let's type 20 maybe. It's 21. Okay, so this is our rain. If you see here, the first eyeball is almost having more than 19. So here the values are almost less than 4 millimeter per hour, and this is almost 10 millimeter per hour, this patch here. Okay, let's zoom it. So basically here we will get the rain almost up to 25 millimeters per hour. Okay, now if you want to let's say you want to plot a time series of this patch, we will only use fifth level, and then what we'll use is we'll check 200 to 300 maybe, 200 to 300, and then we'll use, let's take from 100 to 200. Okay, in x direction. I keep this different, keep this separate. Okay, now we have selected that one. Yeah, we have selected this eyewall. Now if we want to check the rain in its eyewalls, so what we will do is we'll just take this portion of gridded reflectivity, and we will do is we can just 100 to 100, okay, dot shape. Okay, now type dot mean axis is equal to 0. Okay, and now we can plot it, line plot of 0 2 to 10. Yeah, now this is the rain rate of this eye, of this portion. Okay, I hope you understood quite well. If you want to check the library from this PyScanF, if you want to check the built-in, here is an example file, so you can use that as well. I have used it, I have shown there these kind of things. So yeah, you can check here. Also, if you still are facing some issues, you can just open a issue here. Just type new issue, title, type the problem, what you are facing, or what other improvement you want in this, or if you just want to give your feedback, just open an issue here and submit. We'll get back to you. Okay, have a nice day.